Earlier on the program today, I teased what are the four most expensive words. Well, there you have them right on your screen. This time it's different. They are the most expensive words in the English language, says Ryan Payne, who is the president of Payne Capital Management and a market watcher. This time it's different. Doesn't seem terribly expensive to me.
Well, Sir John Templeton said that, and he has Sir in front of his name, so he has the Queen's blessing, so that's enough for me.
Oh, stop it. Go on.
And basically what it says is we get very complacent sometimes when some trend's been going for a long time. And inflation's been very low now for a decade because we've had very modest economic growth, right? So what you're starting to see is a lot of complacency in the conventional wisdom, which you always got to be careful about what everyone thinks the same thing, is inflation is dead for the future. In fact, Bloomberg just came out with a cover story saying that capitalism killed inflation, and you're starting to see just benign numbers have come through. And if you look at it right now, Stuart, we had like less than 2% inflation last month.
What?
The historical average over the last 105 years is more like 3.25%. So we're way below the historical average for inflation.
So what you're really talking about is complacency.
Yes.
Don't establish conventional wisdom. Don't always go with it. Be more intuitive. I mean, look closely at what you've got. But would you say that conventional wisdom at the moment is that the stock market just wants to go up? This time it's different. We just keep on going up. Would you say that?
Well, again, conventional wisdom has been very bearish on the market this year, right? I've been one of the only bulls that you've had on, I assume, that's been saying that the market's probably going to go higher here, which has actually been against conventional wisdom for the last couple months.
Okay, so you're not complacent.
I'm never complacent.
And you think that this drop of near 400 points today, just a blip, no big deal?
I think realistically, yes, because let's face it, we just hit all-time highs in the market. Now we're down like 2% from those all-time highs, which is not extreme. And we just had some of the best economic data we've seen in a very long time, especially with that unemployment number that came out on Friday, which also speaks to wages growing up, unemployment's down, which means inflation at some point probably is going to kick in, kind of come full circle.
You think so? So you take Sir John Templeton at his word. This time it's different. Maybe it's not different. Maybe we do get some inflation, and that will hurt the market, and it'll hurt the bond market, right?
Well, yeah, I don't think it will necessarily hurt the stock market, because the one thing I like about stocks is they pay dividends, and dividends increase over time, which is what you would call an inflation hedge, right?
Yeah, you're a dividend player?
I love dividends. In fact, you should, any portfolio that you have, dividends are almost 40-50% of your return over the long term. So you want to have a cash flow investment if you're invested in stocks.
Well, especially on a day like this. I mean, if your growth stocks are really tumbling, I mean, Microsoft is way down, Amazon is way down, et cetera, et cetera. You'd like to have something in reserve, which is still going to pay you 4, 5, 6%, right? I mean, that's where you're looking for.
Well, exactly right, right? So every day you own stocks, you're accruing dividends and interest that pay out every quarter, no matter what the market does. And that's kind of like keeping your eye on the prize. Like you talked about Microsoft, that's a perfect example of a stock that was flat for a lot of years, but you kept getting those dividends, you kept reinvesting, and then bam, Microsoft's been off to the races now for the last couple years.
That's true, it has.
Yeah.
I've got Blackstone, which is paying me 6.5%, and I've got some AT&T, which is paying me, I think, 4.5%, nearly 5%. How am I looking?
Well, much better than a 10-year treasury now, like 2.5%, Stuart, so well played.
Thank you very much indeed. Ryan Payne, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Good stuff.